How do I uninstall Windows? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. It's not that uncommon for folks to have what I might refer to as upgrade regret or second thoughts. You go for one version of Windows and you decide that the new one just isn't your cup of tea. And what you want to do is essentially uninstall it. Go back to the previous version. Unfortunately, well, operating systems are different. What you're used to when it comes to uninstalling is you might install a piece of software within Windows, decide you don't want to use it anymore, and you run an uninstallation program, and you're back to where you were before the program had been installed. It's removed. You're back to whatever was there before. The operating system is different because the operating system is, in a sense, everything. It's the stuff that was there before. When you install the operating system, you're not preserving whatever was there before, with a couple of rare exceptions I'll talk about in a minute. But normally, when you install an operating system, you are essentially overwriting at least the old operating system completely, which means there's no undo. There's no uninstall. What there is instead is a reinstall. By that I mean not reinstalling the current operating system, but actually going back and getting a copy of the installation media for the previous operating system, the one you liked, the one you want to go back to, and installing it from scratch. In most cases, that means installing the operating system from scratch. It means reinstalling all of your applications from scratch. It means reinstalling all of your data from your backups or wherever else you might have them. So that's what it takes to uninstall an operating system. It's not an uninstall at all. It's a reinstall of the old operating system from scratch. Now, I did mention there are a couple of exceptions. We saw this with Windows 11. When you upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11, there is a period of time during which you were allowed to say, nope, to say, I want to go back to Windows 10. And that period of time, during that period of time, the Windows 11 setup process actually did save all of the information to be able to revert to Windows 10. That is not common. And in this case especially, it was time limited. You could only do it for a certain period of time. I don't recall if it was 10 days or 30 days, but you get the idea. At some point, you're stuck with what you've got unless you completely install from scratch the version you had before. Now, there is one other safety net. And this is one of the reasons that I so strongly recommend taking a backup image before you upgrade your operating system. The easiest way to revert from Windows version X to Windows version X minus one is to reinstall or restore a backup image of that older version of Windows taken immediately prior to the upgrade. It's a snapshot in time. It will take you back to exactly what your machine was before you installed the upgrade. That is probably the most effective way to, quote unquote, uninstall Windows. But again, remember, you're not uninstalling it. You're actually overwriting the entire hard disk, including the operating system, the applications, and your data. So make sure you've got everything you want preserved somewhere so that you can get it back after you've got that operating system back to where you want it. But that's what it takes. There is no uninstall. There are more painful reinstall or restore solutions you need to use instead. Honestly, my recommendation, whenever folks are balking at the current new version of Windows, live with it. Do your best to accept whatever it is you don't like and move forward. The issue is simply this. The current version of Windows, whatever is currently being delivered by Microsoft, is going to be supported for much longer than whatever your old version was. As I sit here, Windows 10 end of support comes at the end of next year, I think it is, or the year after that. So we've got a window. There's a deadline. Windows 11, on the other hand, will be supported for much, much longer than that. If you can get yourself used to the new version of the operating system, that is my true recommendation. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/130374. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.